Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, I'm going to cover a little bit of Excel basic slash possibly intermediate. It's how to custom format your dates in Excel. Let's go ahead and dive right in. I have Microsoft Excel running. I've got a blank file. I'm going to go do this in D1. If you want to follow along with me, feel free to crank up Excel and do this. I'm going to type in 1/1/2023 to put a date in here. Get your crosshairs, autofill, and just pull this down to row 12 or 13. I'm going to stop at 13. Go back and change the January 5th, just to show you this, to 12/1/23, and then also change the 6th, again, just for demonstration purposes, to August 5th, 2022. That works. Now we've got a list of dates we can use. Highlight your dates. By default, I'm on the Home tab, and in the Number group, it says Date. You've got Short Date in here, and you've got Long Date. Go ahead and select Long Date. If you get the pound signs, auto-fit your column, get between D and E, and double-click. There are your long dates right there. Still leave them highlighted. If you don't like Long Date, go to Short Date. There they are, Short Dates. If you need to get to Format Cells, and I need to because we're going to do some custom formatting, Control 1 or right click Format Cells. I'm going to use Control 1. There's the date format. You've got all these to pick from. So that's the category date. Here are your different types. A lot of people don't know this. The first date you have selected, which is for me D1, is your sample. So when I select something different, the sample changes up here. Some people don't know that. So just so you know, if I wanted to see just the month and the year, I pick March/12. The month is abbreviated as 3 letters. If I want to see it spelled out, I pick the next one. I don't like any of these date formats. So I'm going to show you how to make your own custom format. So go to Custom Category. Get rid of whatever's in this type box. Just backspace through it. Dates are numbers. Notice my sample is 44,927. Excel decided to start counting dates on January 1, 1900. That is the number one. So January 1, 2023 is 44,926 days since January 1, 1900. Here we go. We've got month, we've got day, we've got year. It is totally up to you how you want to format it. I'm going to start off with the month, day, and year format. So 1M gives me January. The number 1 is just 1. 2Ms is 01. 3Ms is January as a 3-letter abbreviation. 4Ms is January spelled out. And here's one that a lot of people don't know. The 5th M will give you the first letter of the month. So I've got a J for January. December would be a D. I am making this up. I'm going to do 3 M's, a period, 1 space bar. So now we're on the day. 1D is 1 because it's January 1. 2Ds is 01. 3 is Sunday. So that's apparently a Sunday as a 3-letter abbreviation. And 4Ds is Sunday spelled out. I'm going to go with 2, a comma, space bar. Now we're on the year. 2Ys will give you, actually just 1Y will give you 23. 3 will give you 3, but I like to make it official. I either do 2Ys or 4. That's just me. There's my sample. I like the way it looks. I click OK. I've got a period after the 3-letter month. I've got a comma after the day. One important note before I do something else fancy with custom formats. I'm not happy with the way this looks, so instead of deleting and doing it from scratch, I'm just going to edit to it. I want to see the day of the week first, so that's the letter D. 1 is 1, 2, 3, period, space bar, 2 M's, a forward slash, or a dash. It's entirely up to you. And another forward slash. I'm looking at my sample, Sunday, abbreviated with a period. Perfect. Click OK. Now here's that point I want to make. If I click on D1 and look in my formula bar directly above column C, it's 1-1-2023. So even though you're seeing S-U-N, M-O-N, T-U-E, if you do a sort, it's still going to sort correctly. So if I right click, go to sort and sort oldest to newest, notice that August 5th, 2022, even though it's the FRI for Friday, does show up before the Sunday, which is 1-1-2023. And my December, which is also a Friday, is down here. So I'm just showing you it still sorts correctly. One more tip about these dates, actually two more tips. If you want the current date in your Excel file, there's a keyboard shortcut for that, and that is Control semicolon. So today is November 28th, 2021, which is a Sunday. Another tip, quick way to change this date to this format that I've already created, just click any one of these. Home tab, clipboard group, format painter. Click it once, click on the date you want to change, widen. There you go. So there's your format painter for dates. Last tip, and we will be done. I get this question a lot. Somebody always tells me this. Let me do this intentionally. I'm going to make this a number format with no decimals. So let's go and decrease the decimal. And I'm typing in today's date, 11. I'm doing it on the keyboard. I'm typing in another date, January 5th, 2024. If you ever type in dates and get numbers, don't get alarmed. Dates are numbers. Current date, January 1, 1900. If I highlight those, change them to general. January 1, 1900 is the number one. That is when they started counting dates in Excel. And the reason they did that is I can take the current date minus that date, 44,527 days since January 1, 1900. So just real simple, either highlight them, make them short date or long date, which will work. Make them a custom format, or again, just use your format painter and drag over both of them. There you go. Let me know if you have any comments or questions about custom formatting dates in Excel, but I'm always working with dates in Excel, and I'm assuming you are also. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell, and all that other jazz. Thank you.